Black people are apes. White people are apes. We're all apes. Racism doesn't make any sense. Now, this is the example that Sam Harris has used. And the kind of thing that people, disingenuous leftists again, will completely take out of context. They would take the first four words of a video like this and say, look what this guy just said. And they won't show the rest of the quote or the rest of the video or give any kind of context. Context is absolutely everything. Context will let you know what the person really thinks, what their motives truly are. And I see this an awful lot. I'm sorry, but again, it's coming from the left. I'm sure there are some people on the right that do it. Perhaps I don't want to be overly partisan on this issue, but it seems like another tool of the left slash far left to shut down and silence their political opponents. And this is shared by people, blue checkmark people on Twitter and, you know, other places like that. There was an incident in Scotland a few years ago where this guy basically went to prison for making a joke. You heard that right. Went to prison for making a joke. And of course you had the likes of the imbecile Diane Abbott supporting this kind of totalitarianism. As you would expect she would. But he got his dog, his pug, to make a Sikh Heil salute. And he said, "Gas the Jews," in the background. Not a funny joke. It's a bit crass. It's in bad taste. I think we can all agree with that. But do we put people in prison for making jokes that are not funny? Really? Not traditionally, no. Not since the Dark Ages. Or not since medieval times, let's say. No, we don't. And I couldn't believe when this happened. A guy actually got sent to prison for making a joke. What is the context? The context is that it is a joke. That's just not very funny. What are his motives? Does he really want to enact another genocide on the Jewish people? Is that where he's coming from? Is that really what he's getting at? Or was it just a joke that didn't land with most people? I would suggest the latter. And he turned this around very good upon his release to a journalist. I don't know if it was a Jewish journalist or who he was, but he said something like, "You don't even know what I said." And he said, "Oh, I do know what you said. Well, what was it?" He said, "Well, you said gas the Jews." And he said, "Well, you just said it. You just said it. You should be sent to prison." And he said, no, well, I was just asking the question." He said, "Yes, exactly. Context matters, doesn't it?" And the guy had nothing to say. He goes, "Oh, well, I guess context actually does matter. But people don't realize until it's them that the light is shone on. You know, it's easy to take away context when it's somebody else that is being scrutinized. You know, a 2-minute course in logic or epistemology would clear this up. And people, they know they're being disingenuous. They know it's just, again, another tool to silence people that you disagree with politically and this and that. But context absolutely matters. It matters because we have to know what people's true intentions are, because then we have some idea of what they will do next. And to take context out of, I mean, when Joe Rogan, that video appeared of him saying the N-word, of course it looked bad. But when you scratch under the surface and, you know, the devil is always in the details. Was he using it as a racial pejorative against black people? Or was he talking about the power of the word? There are people saying, no, that you can never use that word if you're a white person under any set. Really? It's not a word that I like or a word that I use, but it's ridiculous to say something like that. What about a class in etymology when you're talking about the power of language and the evolution of a word like that? You know, it's literally a class on that word, and you're saying that you can't say it? That's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Context is everything. You know, and I'm going to title this video, Black People Are Apes. It's very provocative, obviously, but if YouTube, they've already shadow banned me because of my reprehensible opinions, but if they ban the video, they're going to absolutely prove my point for me, is that people don't bother to scratch under the surface to find out what somebody really thinks. And you might say, okay, yeah, you're an insignificant nobody. About three people watch your videos. Why would they bother doing this? But they do this with people that are, you know, have millions of subscribers. I've seen this happen ad nauseum with people. So you know, it'd be interesting to see what YouTube's responses, if the video is banned or taken down, then they're absolutely proving my point for me. You know, as most of you already well know.